njala awo ke tenga silenzi pu abo bana ba kumbi sinjala aye ye baso abo bana ba kumbi sinjala awo ke tenga
I've been looking about to beat him to death. What a song. All right, welcome back. This is TrendingSA on SABC.
You chose that part?
I know, I love it. We can also be streamed around the world, anywhere you understand the beautiful songs of Kwaito.
Maybe not South Korea.
Okay, maybe not South Korea. TrendingSA.tv.
Maybe in South Korea, but not North.
All right, Musa, take over now. What is on your timeline? What's going down, boo?
What's going down, boo?
I don't know if it's the shirt just too tight. Or if it's just so hot, it's just too much. Shoo! Anyway.
In the meantime.
Right, this is what's actually happening right now. Right, so we're getting ready for the updates for the day. And of course, we're going to start things off with one that is pretty, pretty exciting. And you know what that's all about. Updates for the last time this week.
Woo-hoo!
Don't get too excited.
Oh, sorry.
All right, please, don't
apologize.
Hashtag Villa popped up on my feed today. And of course, this is after... Tsonga musician Benny Muyengani hosted a show named Fill Up Giyani Stadium.
Now, yes!
That Casper Nyovest plans to sue Benny for using hashtag Fill Up because he owns it as a trademark. Now, according to reports, 3 weeks ago, Casper's team contacted Benny's team to warn them not to use the concept hashtag Fill Up, as it would be a copyright infringement. But the organizer of Fill Up Giyani was like, never. And that was Howard Mushava. He claims that a few months ago, he checked to see if hashtag Fill Up was indeed a trademark, and he found that it was not. So, of course, had their field day, and EFF chief, CIC commander-in-chief, Julius, had this to say. Starting off with his tweets, and it goes, "We will defend you, chief, at Benny Mayengani. Don't be scared of bullies who are threatened by talent. We have the best in town." Brackets, advocate Talimpo for
Yebo.
Let them bring it on. Hashtag, and he uses it, infringing copyright, saying, "Fill up Giyani Stadium." Oh my gosh. And then there were more tweets. This one here coming through from Thomas saying, "Dear Casper, can I have permission to hashtag fill up this bottle
with hilarious water?"
And then another one was, "Casper always talks about inspiring. Now he's actually inspired someone to fill up a stadium and he's suing him for hashtag fill up. LOL, just let another black man."
Ha, ilula.
Now, this December, Benny plans to have a hashtag fill up pizza Mukaba Stadium at the same time that Casper Vest will be having Fill Up Moses Mapidia. It's going to be interesting. Ladies, what's your take on this?
I think it's absolutely childish. I mean, Ulanduza Ubrenda Fassi was filling up stadiums, filling up Igurup Center decades ago, and I don't understand why this little boy is going on. Like, it's my concept. Calm down, Lala.
Yeah, I mean, okay, so you're a millennial, Musa. You can relate to this. You guys, when you were born, you think that that was the first day of history. Like, you know, what about, like, the history of life? Things that had happened before that, like, I mean, like, Cooley was calling herself Debunge way before.
Debunge. And also, you know, we've had money, so this whole suing thing, because you got money, it's very boring.
Oh, wow.
Let's be calm.
Okay, okay. Plot twist. Could this not be some sort of hint at a collaboration
attention
of some
seeking
sort, or some sort of something, you know, fill up this stadium all the way to that stadium? I don't know. I don't take anything at face level
Maybe
anymore.
Maybe they are working together.
I just feel
in the
like
crooked place.
No. If this thing is a real thing, if there's a trademark registered, everyone must pay. They must pay you and I guess, but they must pay you.
He hasn't trademarked it. That guy proved that he lied.
No, he checked it a few months ago. They spoke to them 3 weeks ago. Please, let's not do this. Anyway, as you know, on Thursdays, we turn back the hands of time. Look at hashtags that never got around to being on your screens, like hashtag cheating partners be like, which trended quite some time ago. And of course, we had to bring it back. And of course, it trended because, look, our people are just tired. They're tired of being lied to, deceived, them shiga-shiga, the tomfoolery, and all that nonsense that no good partners put them through. So let's take a look at what some of you...
I'm angry because of Shiga Shiga.
Okay, let's see, yeah.
Damn, Shiga Shiga.
Started saying cheating partners be like, problem with your hore, how not trust. Now, ladies, let me tell you this. If your man comes to you and he says, "Is it because you don't trust me?"
Aye.
Know that he did it. All right, another one from Real Matro saying that cheating partners be like, that's my auntie's uncle's brother's great grandfather's sister. So chill, relax. And then, of course, the last is from Lady Mo saying that cheating partners be like, when answering their other girlfriend's calls, hello? I can't hear you properly. Let me just move out. Let me just move around. And stuff. Well, these are all just excuses. And of course, this is clearly the theme in all of this and in this hashtag. And some of the cheaters use some pretty elaborate excuses where they pretended they were concerned about their partner's safety. Oh, look at this. It reads, cheating partners be like, I can't put you as my picture. What if they take you?
What you are takeable.
They take you.
Listen, on a side note, that is one of the most adorable meme babies ever. I love her. Okay, so my thinking about heartbreak, right? Mm. About any sort of like negative feeling is to turn your pain into your art. Yeah, that's really what it is. So if you were to think about the greats, they all did it.
What?
S-E-X. Yes. Oh. And then heart, B-R-E-A-K.
Yeah. Oh,
and then
C-R-Y.
Yeah. But then also W-R-I-T-E.
Yeah.
And S-I-N-G. Yeah. And then they make guap.
Yeah.
G-A-U-P.
Guap.
Yes. G-U-A-W.
Guap.
Anyway, yeah. So you get what I'm saying, right? Adele did it. She wrote about all her heartbreak. Taylor Swift wrote about all her heartbreak.
Karen White, I'm not your superwoman.
Hey, we're not.
And in the morning, I make breakfast.
And you know what? Jill Scott is one person who writes poetically about all the things that have happened in her life or things that she's observed. And one of the things that I love the most is this video, right? So Jill Scott getting in the way. She walks all the way up to that girl's door to fetch her. You stole my Hey, sugar honey girl, fly, fly away. I've been lady up till now, I don't know how much more I can take. Queen should swing, if you know what I mean. But I'm about to take my rings off, Preach. Give me some Vaseline.
Yes, sister.
Yes, girl.
I love it, I love it. She turned her pain into art.
Yes, yes, okay. Lala. And then there was that weepy song from O'Kelly Price, Ulala S.C.T. She was a friend of mine, she left with my man, she lied and cheated, took all I had. She was a friend of mine, she used what she knew, she lied, cheated, and left me confused.
Sing it.
Why?
What? Oh. That was a remix.
A remix. Look, I'm the bunch.
Yes, you are. The bunch, everybody.
Guys, do you know that I used to work for Sony Music, right?
Yes.
So I worked there 2003, 2004, the time when
those years.
When the Beyonce's debut album came out. And I was the marketing assistant for international marketing for all the international repertoire, which meant like I did some of the PR on Beyonce's debut album.
Wild.
I got to meet Beyonce, I got to meet your dad, it was crazy. I was in this amazing relationship, I was so in love. I left the record label to start at my own label with my boyfriend, and we were so in love, and then he left me for another woman. And then I had this Beyonce CD in the car, and I paid it for like 10 years. this is the party. She cuts her hair. Remember? And she was like, me, myself, and I was all I got in the end. And then I found out, and I ain't no need to cry. Now on, I will be my own best friend. And I have been my own best friend since.
Oh, mom. So you send yourself birthday cards.
Yeah, I send myself birthday cards.
And flowers.
And flowers.
You got it.
Oh.
And the pens.
All those songs about women or people that were cheated on. But we never address the perspective of the cheater. The cheater, the one that does the things to you that eat you up inside.
Yes.
Like my girl Rihanna, Fenty Beauty, when she sang Unfaithful. Okay, wait, I need to see. I don't wanna do this anymore.
Son of nose.
I don't wanna be the reason why. Every time I walk out at all, I see her die a little more inside. I don't wanna hurt her anymore. I don't wanna take away her life.
This is why people are single.
I don't wanna be.
Sis.
And then it rhymes.
And then it
rhymes. Away.
I remember those days.
Away now.
Yes, like.
Are you a murderer?
No, not that guy. I was the one getting cheated on.
He took the Hippocratic oath. He can't be a murderer. Hashtag section 377. Now that trended worldwide after a historic event took place in India. So the Indian Supreme Court announced that homosexuality would no longer be considered a crime. Wow. Oh my gosh. So there were so many petitions submitted by celebrities in India who challenged the colonial era section 377, which criminalized consensual gay sex. Now, the law was introduced way, way, way back in the crooked place by the British Empire in 1861 to impose Victorian era biblical Christian beliefs and things of that nation. So people were talking all over. I mean, in India, conversations taking place left, right, and center. And of course, people took to the social media and they tweeted their thoughts like this. This is Swatcat saying, I'm kind of convinced that the Section 377 verdict was deliberately postponed so that it would be given today on the 6th of the 9th. Should I get it?
I get
69.
It.
Oh, yeah.
2018.
Yeah.
2018.
No. Oh, man. Yeah. All right. This is from Ritesh. Ritesh says, justice for all, freedom for all, freedom to choose, freedom to be. This is my country. This is our country. This is India. This is a historical moment. Hashtag section 377. Yay! And this is from Puri saying, it doesn't matter who you love, love is love. So happy today. Can you believe it?
Happy Lesbian
Thursday.
Can you
believe it?
It's about time.
Okay. Yeah. Let me break it down for you, right? What they've done is historical, and it actually is quite an example to other countries around the world who still consider same-sex marriage, and in some places, same-sex sex, a crime. It's shocking that in the globe, on the globe, there are 196 countries, but there are only 26 countries where same-sex marriage and same-sex is decriminalized. Isn't that shocking
That's
to
disgusting.
You?
That's
disgusting. Can I do that in maths for you? That means that 88% of the world still considers gay consensual sex illegal. 88%
of the world is still legislatively homophobic.
Uh-huh. Correct.
Is that not shocking? So in the Netherlands, they passed the law in the year 2000. Here in South Africa, we're very progressive for an African country. Eh? Which is like supremely important. Yeah. This was passed in 2006, and just last year, Germany joined in.
Wow.
Yeah, but look, another place that has recently passed something is the Republic of Ireland, where we became the first country in the world to ask their citizens to vote on the same-sex marriages to be legalized. And 60% of Irish citizens voted in favor of same-sex marriage. Nice. And the truth still remains that even though it is a law that says you can now marry someone, sadly, the views on homophobia of the people are still there. So for instance, in South Africa, there's a huge problem that we have of corrective rape, where people feel like you cannot be a lesbian. Mm. You cannot sleep with another woman. Yeah. So as a man, I'm going to take or give you something to turn you back into a woman.
I wouldn't say people think, I would say animals think. There's an insult to animals as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Very strange.
It's absolutely disgusting. Speaking of homophobic views, just the other day, new rap star Boy Tutulo was trending because of a homophobic tweet from 2009 that was found. Must join in. Uti, me. What is up with the gay on these soapies? This side is undecided lesbians, on the other side is sucking tongues. Mwah. And then she has gone on to apologize, stating that she was only 19 and naive. It's clear that a change of law doesn't mean a change of mindset. There's another one there that you can read a decade ago. I was naive, homophobic, young. I didn't know better. I was 19. My views on sexuality were warped. We grow our lives. We grow. Our views change and we do better. It's gut-wrenching and embarrassing to see them now. However, I'm not the same person I was 10 years ago. Nice one, Dasekai. Nice one, Dasekai.
That speaks to the thing I was speaking about, you know, with global leaders acknowledging change,
yes,
you know, and acknowledging social transformation, and we are changing and we are transforming and we are re-socializing ourselves and each other through things like this. And it's sad for me that there aren't more global government rules against othering, you know, like in any form, you know, like, you know, oh, you're this or you're that, you're anything other than what I am, and I'm the person that controls the power in the world. So it's gross.
It's disgusting.
Yeah, you know, let us change.
I've made it part of my mission statement with everything that I do, that every platform that I have, every talent that I have, I will be an ally, no matter what. So on radio, we're always discussing issues about, you know, the various things that a person goes through in their lived experiences, being othered by 88% of the world, and being part of, you know, any campaign or mission that really is all that I want to do, be an ally.
Yeah. I think a lot of the time the problem are people, or is people, because very easily we don't care much about the things that we do. You know, if you're heterosexual, you have your girlfriend, you can kiss in the street, you can do whatever you want to do in your bedrooms. But the moment someone else, a man and a man, a woman and a woman, get together, you feel like you need to police them in their bedroom, like you're not allowed to sleep with each other. No. Which is snacks, I feel. People must just mind their own business.
I always love, do you Happy have like lesbian a group of people like, oh, we're the missionary gang and you can only do missionary?
That's hilarious.
Thank you.
Nina Hasty, everybody. We'll be right back after this. On SABC3, and we're also online on TrendingSA.tv. So let's check on some of your social media posts, shall we? Juicy tea, our power. Mm. Oh, Dr. Musa. Oh, I'm adding in this. Sorry. Okay, let me go again. Oh, Dr. Musa, let me read it. I so love your singing talent.
Yeah. God given.
Bono says, oh, Dr. Musa, you got me singing along to that Rihanna song. Nice one, Dr. Musa.
You know why?
Oh, yeah?
That song speaks to people's hearts because they listen to it. It was playing on your V360 or on that Samsung.
No, you know all the technology.
It's a millennial thing.
He probably think that he... Never mind.
So listen, thank you very much for all of your posts and RTs and everything else that you sent to us. We really, really enjoy receiving everything you send. It's time now for Worth a Follow.
My band.
That's
keep
right,
going.
Abby. Emma, you know
right.
She can stop it.
That's right.
Sorry. Okay. Our worth partner tonight, we are profiling a brand that you guys are already following on socials. This is the one page that makes you wish you had all the money in the world to buy all the beautiful clothes that they have. Yes, you guessed it. I'm talking about Style Alert SA. Now, the brand is run by Joburg-based self-taught stylist, designer, and fashion buyer, Thuli Mola, whose brand caters to the everyday high demands of women who find joy in mixing modern day-wear with a twist of vintage. Now, she's currently sitting on over 200 thou. Fashion followers on Instagram, a platform that she's used to advertise most of her clothes. So what I love about Style Alert SA is the fact that it's all about timeless style. So when it comes to buying anything, it has to be like a classy piece, something you can pass on to the next generation, you know, something quality. A cool thing about Style Alert is that she doesn't source clothes from over the seas. They are all proudly South African made.
That's stunning.
This woman's hustle, and for continuing to make women feel good about themselves, because that's what we need.
And the great thing is she's saving the environment.
Yes, because of transport costs, etc., etc.
And you know, people don't think about that when you talk about recycling fashion, right? That's a really great way to celebrate Arbor Week. Buy yourself something fabulous and secondhand. It's now time for that was your worth of follow. You can follow them at Style Alert SA. It's time now for Vava's J's, Iskuli.
Right, tonight on Vava's J, we take a look at old school boy bands and some of their signature dance moves that had kids in the 90s and early 2000s gyrating in front of mirrors, catching feelings they never knew anything about. Okay, so let's take a look at one of the classic videos so that you can get an idea of what I'm talking about. Gyrate, baby, gyrate.
Yo, fellas, y'all ready to do this?
Yeah, yo, what's up, y'all?
Boys are in effect, and it's about time.
Yo, let's bring this up.
Boys are in. Boys are in. Boys are in.
Again. Diggy, diggy, diggy.
No, that was good, man. I've never seen that video in my life. But I can tell you this. I can do those moves much better than they can.
Let's see.
Okay, watch this.
Millennial
so that
confidence.
You understand.
No, let's watch. Let's watch.
I'm telling you. All right.
Shame with respect. Okay. Sorry, I saw
fine.
You.
Okay, it's fine.
All
right, cool.
Okay, you can stop now. Stop. We get the picture, Musa. Really.
Something on your shoe.
That was fantastic. Frightening, my friend.
We get the picture. Right, we continue. Okay, we told you that you get the picture. So we're moving on now. Guys, we continue with the boy bands. You guys remember those white boys who sounded like Britney Spears on steroids? NSYNC was their name. Yes, so the ones who overused the styling gel, and even Justin Timberlake was part of it.
Timberlake.
Anyway, let's refresh your memories. Let's check out the guys with the greasy hair.
Look, me, I can dance like NSYNC.
Show us.
I was up in the genre. We all had crushes on the NSYNC gang. And also, sometimes when we're watching TrendingSA and you guys can see, we're totally NSYNC.
Oh, wow.
I'm
come on, everybody.
I'm ready for this.
Yeah, that was good.
Okay.
That was good.
I was hitting myself in the head. And then you got to do this part.
Wow. Nice one. Okay, thank you very much, guy. Another iconic band that I want us to check out is Trompi.
Listen.
Absolute.
Legends. Legendary. Now, I know definitely you don't even know who they are, right?
I know
Drogas. Oh, you know them?
I mean, Pumelokshini, babes.
Big ups to you, babes. But do you know the moves? Let's do the moves. You know the moves, right? Let's do the moves. Let me school you on the moves.
That was hard. That was hard, Babzin. Now still on the local
church
scene.
Mother during the day.
Tavern owner at night.
At night.
Okay, guys. Now still on the local scene. Thank you very much, tavern owner. Still on the local scene. So before I tell you who the next band is, I know that they probably don't qualify as a boy band, but it would be a sin not to recognize Ladysmith Black Mambazo for their consistency and their contribution to the music industry in South Africa and internationally and in Africa. Let's see if we can pull off one of their moves to the song. Hello, my baby. Everyone, let's get up. Let's get into position. Let me lead you guys. Are you guys ready? Hello, my baby.
It's finished now. We're going to take a quick break. That's it for Mama's Jam. Listen, when we get back, we have our legendary guest, STHANDIWE KGOROGE, right here. Give us the music, please.
Jealous my man. about me. I mean, most of it is true. I'm an asshole. I've hurt women, I'm kinda rude, but I ain't that broken. I got issues, but I've improved. Really had hope. My big heart was bulletproof. I was under the impression that people just engineered up.
Welcome back. You're still watching TrendingSA on SABC3. I'm so excited for our next segment. Thank you, by the way, for all of your tweets and posts and everything else. Now, our legendary guest tonight is an accomplished actress. Sorry, I'm just taking my shoes off.
Still the bunch.
Very hot. It's an accomplished actress and businesswoman. Some of you might remember her as Zoe, who was the dedicated teacher on Yeezo season one.
Yeah. Sure.
A role for which she won the Avanti Award for Best Supporting Actress.
Sure.
Wafile support. Since then, she has gone on to star in numerous other productions, such as The Road, Fallen, and Heartlines, just to name a few. But she simply describes herself as an unapologetically African storyteller. Don't you love that, ladies and gentlemen? You're going to love her. STHANDIWE KGOROGE.
Yes, queen. Yes, queen.
Well, I mean, hey, a variety of things. We want to say everything, we want to do all things. First of all, you look amazing.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
It's really good to have you here.
Thank you, guys.
All right, let's start a little bit at the beginning, right? Born?
Yeah.
KZN?
No, born in Ohio.
All right. Oh. So, and then what? Your family originally comes from KZN. That's the thing. And then so you're raised in all of these environments internationally where the faces reflected to you aren't the faces that you see when you look at yourself in the mirror. Yeah. So tell me about some of that identity, you know, grappling with
Ohio.
That.
Yeah. No, Ohio, I don't really remember because obviously I came back at 3 and from there, we lived KwaMaphumulo, which is northern KwaZulu-Natal, and then Canada.
Canada, yes.
Those are the images you're seeing now with my brothers in the snow.
My gosh.
So you can imagine, it's Edmonton, Alberta, Canada.
Whoa.
You hardly see another brown person. Every time you see them, it's like,
yeah.
They're also like, hey, bro,
I don't know you.
Yeah, I don't know you. You know? So, yeah, and that's why representation was so important at a very young age.
Yeah. Mm.
As the moment I just saw someone who looked like me, it was literally a big deal. I remember seeing this girl at school. I went to Hazel Dean Republic School, and she was like probably 4 grades ahead of me. I went up to her, I was like, hey, how are you? Those girls are picking on me. And she's like, so, go sort them out. I was like, okay.
So you thought you'd found an ally.
I thought we'd be on time, like,
your sister.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mm. That's so interesting. That's so interesting. Yeah. And the story about the towel around
you
your head.
That. Because everyone I saw had beautiful, long, silky hair.
Mm.
So I would get home, literally put some socks in to...
Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm. And the white towel.
That has no color.
Yeah, no.
That has no color.
And I'll put a long towel around me and act like Cynthia, my best friend, who had this gorgeous, you know, beautiful long hair. And because for the longest time, I wanted to look like everyone else. And that was the cool thing, to look like everyone else. No one had my hair that was this short that my mom made sure that she cut because she couldn't maintain it in Canada.
Yes.
There weren't enough products, or if any. So,
that's so interesting.
But it was interesting that through that, my parents were that voice who kept on trying to reaffirm me. But if... You know, you spend most of your time at school.
Yeah.
So all you hear most of the time is, you know, this. Yeah. How come your skin's like this? Oh, look at Sitandi's hair, skin. You know, so, yeah.
Unbelievable.
Sure.
Yeah. So your evolution then into this prolific actress. But then more than an actress, because you're quite an activist for, you know, heritage, for culture, and of course, being a businesswoman as well. So talk to me about that evolution in your life and career.
That was organic, because I think I've literally always been that person. I've always been selling something. On campus, I was that kid getting secondhand coats and selling them to the kids from Joburg in Pietermaritzburg. I went to UKZN in Pietermaritzburg.
Very clever.
And that's my mom because she was a nurse. And then that person for me who would use whatever platform and space that he had in his own studios in Mali to just really try and give beauty to, you know, a dire condition, whatever the conditions were of the people there. That's why when you look at all his pictures in terms of what Malik Sidibe was doing in his studios, it would be people who didn't really even have money, but they would come in there for just that moment, with whether he had a bike or a helmet or whatever. He would just give you that moment of escapism. You're beautiful. He would celebrate you. So when Mbali Soga, who's the editor of True Love, asked me to do something for Valentine's Day, I wanted to steer away from the obvious in terms of
cherubs.
Red and white. Absolutely, cherubs. You know, I really wanted to use the platform to say, kids need to look around them and not go through what we went through of saying, I don't see black love. I don't see black people who love each other. And I just thought, let me use Malik Sidibe in terms of his work as a reference and then use that as the platform.
Stunning, Basaka, you said that when you lived in Canada, you hardly saw faces that looked like yours. And I also know that when you were raised in South Africa, as I was raised in South Africa, that Abantu Abamnyama were telling you about how dark you were. Colorism is very, very close to your heart. What are you doing about this issue?
I've recently partnered with, we would not mention the company, but it's a big brand, right? And for me to partner with them, and I think I'm one of seven of the women that they've approached to drive the narrative of black girls and representation, black girls and skin, black girls and hair, black girls and self-esteem, because that's where a lot of society's problems, as we know, stem from those things. If we don't sort out that foundation, things go wrong. If I'm an adult at my age, I still have those issues of someone saying, yo, I just saw something on Twitter yesterday where this guy said that woman would have looked beautiful. Did you see it?
No.
Yeah. She would have looked beautiful if she was just lighter. And the other guy says, what's wrong with her dark skin? He says, dark skin looks dirty. This is 2018 and we're really still saying that.
And these are black people saying this?
Yeah,
these are black people. And how do they expect other races to look at us?
Absolutely.
Wow.
So we're so messed up because of what's happened in the past in all countries.
And where did the makeup, natural? Like, natural, but it's like peach.
Yeah.
In Africa, natural
is peach.
So, not so long ago, you posted something that sort of speaks along the lines of self-love. Let's have a look at your tweet. And it reads, some days I think I've got it all figured out. Some days I don't. I don't know if I'm coming or going, but guess what? It's okay. Nothing in this life is perfect or perfectly balanced. And then continues thereafter. So, it's on self-love, but there are many challenges that come along with self-love. I mean, we live in a very bad world with so many negative things that come left, right, and center. So how do you get that to the top of your priority list in such a bad world?
I love the fact that you said on top of your priority list, because it has to be a priority. Because otherwise, if you're, like, that's why they always say on a flight, put on the oxygen mask, take care of yourself. The first time I heard that, I was like, how selfish is that? Like, what about my kids? But honestly, it has to be about you taking care of yourself. And there's nothing bad about that. We've been raised so much to feel like there's something wrong with you switching off and just saying, it's about me and I need to preserve. And that's why we have a lot of people committing suicide. Because society says, let us just fit into this machinery of being everything for everyone
else,
next thing you've forgotten all about yourself. So I think it's okay. It's literally okay to say, hey, no one's perfect. Everyone's going through what they're going through every single day, but it's about getting there every day and showing up and doing the best that you can. That's all we can do.
Beautiful.
Yes, absolutely. Listen, I mean, you show up, you do the best. You've just done the most with Uncovered, which is a South African film, action-packed thriller that we're really looking forward to. Tell us, it's got top local stars in. What are we, as Tina, the fans, are we going to expect?
Thriller, which I'm so proud of, because I think, as you know, South Africans, we hardly go there. You know, we love telling stories sometimes that are really not It's just fine. It's just a thriller. It's a well-written script directed by Zugo Nodada and his wife, who is the producer, Utandega. So it's a family-run production called First Chapter Productions.
Cool.
It's a beautiful little movie that we shot in Newcastle. So we were there literally for full 4 weeks.
Oh, wow.
We
wow.
just got back from
beautiful
that.
Beautiful landscape.
Yeah.
So but that's coming out next year.
Okay.
Early next year.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, great. Beautiful. Yeah. We're looking forward to it.
It's Heritage Month.
Yes.
I'd like to hear your thoughts as a storyteller, as, you know, somebody who really believes in identity and heritage being so important. What are your thoughts in this month?
I think we really need to get to a point where we're not just about celebrating the month, and next thing it's we move on, it's October, November. What does it mean to preserve, right? Mm. Because I know a lot of people know that I love vintage so much, and because I'm really about that, I'm always saying, guys, this time here is so limited. Who will document that we were here?
Yeah. Mm.
And especially as Africans, we don't, even my love of vintage, I struggle. I'm like, what were Zulus wearing in the 1900s? You know, I want to see that. And we know we were big on beading.
Natural products.
Beautiful things, but we don't have those things documented. And every time you want to see a lot of things that have to do with African history or fashion or anything, they're like, oh, go to the University of Reading.
Mm.
They've got but that's not in Africa. Where's our stuff here that's documented for our kids to say, oh yeah, my parents were wearing this in 1980s, the whole skateboard or the punk culture. It must just be like the tip.
Right.
So we need to...
This is sure it was from
heritage.
The Dutch, and we're saying it's ours.
Yeah, we thought it's
madness.
Ours. Absolutely.
Well, listen, you've inspired a lot of thoughts, and I'm sure everybody at home is just so delighted. Thank you very much for spending some time
with us. Wow, guys, thank you for having me.
You're
a pleasure. It's about time.
Thank you for coming. It is. Okay, everybody, we'll take a quick ad break. This is Trending SA on SABC3.
Aina Koras.
That's still a jam. Welcome back to SABC3's Trending SA. Musa, what have you got on WhatsApp? On WhatsApp.
What's up?
If you guys remember, this week was Beyonce's birthday week. It will continue to be her birthday month, her birthday year,
her birthday decade,
her birthday century, her birthday millennium.
You can go on until infinity.
Okay, I just want you guys to see this.
I can't wait to marry you, my love.
That's not the best one I've ever seen.
What was supposed to play was a video of Beyonce and I singing together in birthday next year.
Yeah, we knew that was never going to happen.
No, but it's corrupted, that thing, because we put a protection
encryption.
Protection encryption. Yes.
Yes,
Musa. That's how we wrap up things on Trading SA. Corruption, protection, encryption until Monday. We're encrypted now.
Now we are
until
subscription. Monday.
Then you can subscriptionize back to us at 10:30 right here on SABC3.
But prescription.
We'll see you again. For the right, laughter, and joy, prescription. Ha! See you on Monday. Bye-bye.
Happy Lesbian Thursday, beauties.
Love you.